We have all seen a weather map explained in two dimensions like this. And there are plenty of airports and remote automated weather station data out there. All of these observations are taken at the surface and can't fully paint a picture of the atmosphere. So if the atmosphere has a height component to it, how do we measure it? And how do we figure out what is going on above us? Well, there are a few ways to approach this problem, and our most consistent way is launching a weather balloon. A balloon that transports a weather instrument called a radiosonde.
Way high up into the sky.
Which helps us diagnose and analyze the atmosphere vertically. This little guy right here measures temperature, dew point, and sends a GPS signal back
to this tower here.
Which then goes into our computer system where GPS data is calculated, giving us wind speed and direction and pressure above. The National Weather Service has 92 stations that take observations twice a day, 5 a.m. and 5 p.m. Central Time in the winter, and 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. Central Time in the summer. We do this every day of the year, even if it's snowing or raining. We need something lighter than air to carry the radiosonde up, so we fill the balloon up with hydrogen. The balloon starts out 5 feet in diameter, and as it travels up into the atmosphere, it can expand up to 25 feet across. That's the size of a small house. While approximately reaching an elevation of 120,000 feet, or 18 miles up in the atmosphere, so that's about 4 times the height of Mount Everest. With all this data at our disposal, it allows our weather models to forecast with more precision. Balloon data comes in very handy during severe weather, allowing us to verify how unstable the atmosphere is. Weather balloon data provides vital upper air observations to help enhance our mission of protecting life and property by the issuance of forecasts and warnings.